Hello all, welcome to C Programming Learning. In this video, we'll understand C structure. In C programming, a structure or struct is a collection of variables that can be a different data type under the single name. When it comes to collection of variables in an array, we need to provide the same data type in that. But when it comes to structure, you can make a collection of different data types variables also. So here is the syntax of structure. So, first of all, you have to write down a keyword struct and then structure name of your choice. And inside that, providing different data type, you can define any structure member. And then you can put the variable name after this in this way. There is another way to declare the variables inside the structure. Like you have to define the structure first here and you have to declare the variables here, like structure name P1, structure name P1. Suppose the name of my structure is structure name and the first entity is P1, and then again P1, then again P2, then again P3. Like this way also you can declare your variables. For example, when you are creating suppose a data structure, the name of my structure is data. So I am writing struct data. Inside that I'll declare three entities with different data types: character, integer and float. So you have to declare like character name, integer number, float, percentage. So in the structure data, you can define different data type collections. If you want to access any structure variable, then you have to write down variable name, member name by using a dot type is equal to value. For example, my variable is student. My member name, that means what entity I want to prove or I want to declare, that is name, and then its value. So here in this program, we will define one structure, we'll declare it, and then we'll declare the members of the structure, and then we are going to print the same. For that, let's open code blocks. Here I'm going to start with my empty file. So I'll write down first of all hash include stdio.h. After that, I'll save this file first, because then you will understand the color change. So I'll change is mystruct.c, and then I'll start with my structure. So I'll use a keyword struct, and then I'll give name as a student data. So this is the name of my structure. Now I'm going to declare who will be inside my structure. So let's open this. So here I'm not going to use any semicolon. So here I'll write down character. When it comes to character, you have to provide an asterisk sign, because then and then only it can allocate the value to given variable. So I'll write down student name. So I'll write down s name, and then I'll use one integer for s id, that is student id, and then I'll use again integer for let's get for s age, student age. So I have declared three different data types inside under the name of student data in a structure. I'm not going to provide my variable declaration over here again, and then I'll use a different method by using an integer main, as I have shown in your syntax. So inside integer main, first I'll declare my first variable. So I'll write down struct. The name of my structure is student data, struct student data. In that struct student data, my first variable is student 1. So here I am going to provide the information about student 1 under the syntax of structure. So first I'll write down student 1 dot s name. So this way I can access the variable. And I'm going to provide the name as suppose John. So here I have provided the first name. Then I'll provide the value for another variable, student dot s id. Let's give id as 456, and then student dot s age. Let's put s age as a 17 years. So here I have given those three. Now I'm going to do is I'm going to display the values of my struct members. So I'll use a printf statement. Inside printf statement, I'm going to give the first line as student. Oh, here I have to put student 1 because my name is student 1. So I'm writing student 1 name is, and here I'll put first slash n because we are going to print 3 entities. So student 1 a name is, and then I have to use a format specifier, that is %s for printing the name, and then here comma I will write down student 1 dot s name. So this way it will assign the value to student 1. And then what I'll do is I'm going to use the same for all the another two declared variables value. Here I'm copying and I'm pasting student 1. Now here is the age. Oh no, first is ID with a % d format specifier, and here will be the change of student 1 dot ID. Here will be student 1 age with % d format specifier, and here it the change is SID. So we have used 3 printf statements to print 3 values with a written 0. So this way I have written my program of declaring my structure and then putting values and then accessing those members and displaying the values of them. Let's build this file. If build finished with 0 errors, it's good to go to run. So as you can see here, student name is John, student ID is 456, student age is 456. So here why it is showing student age is 456? Because we have not changed it to S age. So I have to change it to S age. Now let's build and run again and let's see if it is showing S age is to 17. I'm building and running it again. As you can see here, student age is 17. I hope you understood how to define a structure, how to declare members of different data types, how to put value, how to access the number, and how to print the values of struct members. Thank you.